This is a pre-built version of the application, so if we go ahead and run it. Now suppose a company's hiring decision is based on two interviews, and the score for each interview is on a scale of 0 to 10, and this is the score for candidate interview number 1, and this is the score for his second interview. And support vector machine sequential minimal optimization was implemented here, and we obtained this decision boundary and found those three support vectors. And the candidates to this side of the boundary were not hired, and those to this side were hired, and this candidate was misclassified. Next, let's go ahead and classify some new candidates and try to predict, based on their interview scores, if they will be hired or not. So a candidate with those two scores was classified as -1, which means we have a will not be hired prediction. And another candidate with those two scores was classified as 1, which means we have a will be hired prediction. I will start by creating a new Python file. And this is training data that we will be using. And this column will contain the score for interview number 1, and this one for interview number 2, and this column will contain the label, and +1 means the candidate was hired, and -1 means he was not. And the X array will contain the scores, and the Y array the labels. And let's go ahead and import NumPy, since we will need to use that for matrices operations. And all the SVM logic will be in this class, which will have two matrices, an X matrix containing the features and a Y matrix containing the labels, and they're both initialized in this constructor. And we will call it from here, passing in X array and Y array as matrices. Now, before going any further, let's do a quick introduction. So, support vector machine is a hyperplane separating a set of positive and negative items with a maximum margin. And this is the formula for the output of a linear support vector machine, and the objective is to find W and B for a hyperplane with a maximum margin. Now, in order to maximize the margin, we end up with the following optimization problem. We want to minimize this equation subject to this constraint. And the way we solve this type of problems is by using Lagrange. So we subtract the constraints from what we want to do. And alpha here is the Lagrange multiplier, and this is the sum of all the constraints subtracted from this equation. And then we take partial derivative with respect to W and B and set them to 0, and we end up with those two equations. Now, sequential minimal optimization solves solves the smallest possible optimization problem at every step, and the smallest possible optimization problem involves two alpha, since they must obey a linear equality constraint, this one that we just derived here. Meaning changing only one alpha might cause this equation to be violated. And we have two components to SMO, a heuristic to choose which two alphas to optimize, and an analytic method to solve for the two alphas. And at every step, SMO chooses two alphas to optimize together and finds the optimal values for the two, and then it uses the new values in order to update the support vector machine. And let's define and initialize two instance variables, alpha and b. And let me define this maximum number of iterations. And this method will perform sequential minimal optimization. And return the number of alpha pairs optimized, and we will call it from the constructor, while I is smaller than the max number of iterations. And here we will go into a loop, and we had this equation for the output of a linear support vector machine, and we obtained this equation for W. So we take this equation and plug it here. And use it here. And we are subtracting the label, which would give us the error. And let's add this epsilon and this slack penalty, C, that I will be showing what it does later. Now here we calculated the error for the first alpha, and to move forward alpha has to violate KKT conditions, which are that alpha is zero is equivalent to the example being correctly labeled with room to spare, and alpha is equal to C is equivalent to the example being misclassified or in the margin, and alpha between 0 and C is equivalent to the example being a support vector. So this method checks if alpha violates KKT conditions, and we will call it from here. And this method selects the index for the second alpha to optimize, and we will call it in this case, and obtain the index of that second alpha to optimize, and then calculate the error on it. and we will keep a copy of the first and the second alphas. And we want to bound the alpha according to this. And this method will do that. And we will call it from here. And eta is the optimal amount to change the second alpha. And this is how we calculate it. And we use it here to calculate the second alpha, alpha j. And we calculate it here. And this is how we clip alpha j and how we optimize alpha I. And those two methods do that. So optimize alpha I, same as alpha j, but in the opposite direction. And this one is clip alpha j. And we will have this method that optimizes an alpha pair and returns a flag. And we will call it from here. And here we will use this formula to calculate alpha j. And then we will clip it. And let's define here the minimum alpha optimization. And this method will optimize B. And we will call both optimize alpha I and optimize B from here. And this method will calculate and return W. And we will use it here. And this method does classification. And finally, we will have three get methods for alpha and B and W. And here we need to import a pretty table and mat plot lib, and we will have three functions here, one to display the information tables. So one of the tables will contain the support vectors, the label, and the alphas, and another table for the weights and B. And we will have a function to handle command line entry, and a function to plot the data and the decision boundary and the support vectors. And we will call them from here. So first we will display the information tables, and then we will prompt the user to close the display window in order to proceed. And next we plot the data, and when the user closes the display window, we handle command line entry. And finally, let's go ahead and test run the application. So we discovered this decision boundary and those three support vectors, and those candidates were not hired, and those were hired, and this one was misclassified. And those are the W's, and this is the B that we discovered. So if we try one with those two scores, he was classified as -1, which means we have a will not be hired the prediction. And if we try with those two scores, so he was classified as 1, which means we have a will be hired prediction. So let's do one more thing. Let's change C, maybe make it 8, and run it again. So seems like overfitting. So this one became support vector, and those two are still support vectors.